Isaiah chapter 1. The vision of Isaiah the son of Amos, which he saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem, in the days of Uzziah and Jotham, and Ahaz and Hezekiah, kings of Judah. Hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth, for the Lord has spoken. I have nursed and brought up children, and they have rebelled against me. The ox knows his owner, and the ass his master's crib, but Israel does not know. My people does not understand. Ah, sinful nation, a people heavy with iniquity, a seed of evildoers, children who make others rotten. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel to anger. They've gone away backward. Why should you be stricken any more? You will revolt more and more. The whole head is sick, and the whole heart is faint. From the sole of the foot even to the head, there is no soundness in it, but wounds and bruises and putrefying sores. They have not been closed, nor bound up, nor soothed with oil. Your country is wasted, your cities are burned with fire. Your land, strangers devour it right before your eyes, and it is wasted, as overthrown by strangers, and the daughters of Zion is left like a cottage in a vineyard, like a hut in a garden of cucumbers, like a besieged city. Except the Lord of hosts had left us a very small remnant, we would have been as Sodom, and we would have been like Gomorrah. Hear the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom, give ear to the law of our God, ye people of Gomorrah. To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me, saith the Lord? I am full of the burnt offerings of rams and the fat of fed beasts, and I do not delight in the blood of bulls and of lambs or of he-goats. When you come to appear before me, who has required this at your hand to trample my courts? Bring no more vain sacrifice. Incense is an abomination unto me. The new moons and Sabbaths and the calling of meetings I cannot endure. It is iniquity, even the solemn meeting. Your new moons and your appointed feasts my soul hates. They are a trouble to me. I am weary to bear them. And when you spread forth your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Yea, when you make many prayers, I will not hear. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves, make yourselves clean. Put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. Learn to do good. Seek judgment. Make those who are ill-treated happy. Judge the fatherless and plead for the widow. Come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall be as wool. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land, but if you refuse and rebel, you shall be devoured with the sword, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. How has the faithful city become a harlot? It was full of judgment and righteousness lodged in it, but now murderers. Your silver has become dross, your wine mixed with water. Your princes are rebellious and companions of thieves. Everyone loves bribes and is pursuing rewards. They judge not the fatherless, neither does the cause of the widow come to them. Therefore saith the Lord of hosts, the mighty one of Israel, Ah, I will cease myself of my foes, and avenge myself of mine enemies, and I will turn my hand upon you, and purely purge away your dross, and take away all your tin. I will restore your judges as at first, and your counselors as at the beginning. Afterward ye shall be called the city of righteousness, the faithful city. Zion shall be redeemed with judgment, and her returning ones with righteousness. And the downfall of the transgressors and of the sinners shall be together, and those who forsake the Lord shall be consumed. For they shall be ashamed of the oaks which you have desired, and you shall be ashamed for the gardens which you have chosen. For ye shall be like an oak whose leaf fades, and like a garden that has no water. And the strong shall be like tow, and the maker of as a spark, and they shall both burn together, and none shall put them out.
is your name in all of these. Oh Lord, how excellent is your name. Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all of these. Of singers, the infants and babes, you ordain. What is man that you are mindful of him, and the Son of Man that you visit him? Oh Lord, our Lord, your name in all of the earth. Oh Lord, how excellent is your name. Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name.